What's up, everyone? My name is Va, and today I just wanted to look at some stuff about Bill Nye, because Bill Nye has been on the verge of, well, it's been kind of sad lately, because a lot of people are saying Bill Nye is not as good as he used to be, and is a complete worthless idiot. Well, I wanted to see if they're actually right. So today, it leads back to this video. So today, we're going to look at it. So I hope you guys can join me on this journey. So, here we go.
One thing's clear about sexuality. There's a lot more going on than meets the eye. Female or male, gay or straight, pink or blue.
All right, I already see problems with this. One, well, he didn't mention any other colors. I'm red. Okay, well, actually, I don't know if it's skin cancer, it's a birth defect, or I was just, if a fire hydrant, I have fire hydrant genes. I don't know. Last time I checked, my skin is like permanently sunburned. So what about red lives, you know? What about guys with t-shirts over their heads? Like me, Bill, I already see problems with this.
We were taught to see these as binary.
And they should stay binary. You hear me? They should stay binary. Because whatever you say, if you're a girl or a boy, that's it. You can't be anything else. You cannot be an attack helicopter. You cannot be a mix between the two. You can't be koala urine unless you are koala urine. You can't be any of that. So quit being an idiot.
Now we're realizing it's more like a kaleidoscope.
What in koala urine is a kaleidoscope? Oh, that was hard to say. Say that 10 times fast. Koala urine kaleidoscope. Koala urine kaleidoscope. Koala urine kaleidoscope. What is a kaleidoscope? I've heard of a telescope. Okay, I've heard of a microscope. Never heard of a kaleidoscope before. You know what? I'm gonna look up what a kaleidoscope is. So let's see. So this, and these are kaleidoscopes, apparently. You know these things whenever you're on drugs and you see them. Gosh, Bill, are you smoking weed? Are you really? You gotta be smoking some hard freaking crap to think that this is like gender. This is nothing like gender, Bill. What Bill is trying to say is that there are more than two genders, which is completely wrong.
And this stuff isn't just for adults. Parents know this already. Kids explore gender expression, attraction, before they've ever heard of a spectrum.
All right, now this is actually the most sense he's made so far. Yes, and if you don't understand it, here's a little background. Kids at a young age actually do try to, you know, discover attraction and all that other stuff, you know? Young kids do that, and they also find out what other different types of gender like and what they actually do like, you know? So, this is the most sense Bill has made so far.
Take sex. We used to think it was pretty straightforward.
And it still is straightforward. Two different genders, boom, get together, make baby, 9 months later. Okay, that's all it is, Bill. You don't make a baby with a toaster, and then all of a sudden, a baby koala comes out, and then has a freaking soda can for its baby. That's not how genetics works, okay? You're a science man. You're the science guy. You're supposed to know basic genetics. I know basic genetics, and I'm not even the nearest of a scientist. Even though I am. I'm great, but still. Bill! You are a man of science. You know more than this.
X and a Y chromosome for males, two X's for females. But we see more combinations than that in real life. And even for people with just two sex chromosomes, hormones can vary wildly. So can anatomy. What makes someone male or female isn't so clear cut.
Yes, it is. Listen, all right, I'm gonna give you a little rundown, all right? You have a nutsack. Okay, you're a man. If you don't, you're a woman. So, here's what I'm going to tell you to do, all right? If you think there are more than two genders, go outside to your backyard, all right? Find a nice, clear puddle of grass, right? And practice throwing yourself on the ground.
How about attraction? Some people argue the natural thing is to only be attracted to the opposite sex. But in practice, it ain't so simple, kids. Some people are gay, some are bi, some are asexual, and some will take whatever they can get. Know what I mean?
Ha, 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 ha!
are so clever!
It's another sexy sliding scale.
Wow, good alliteration. Guess what, I got one. Bill Nye, he's a guy. I want to poke him in the eye.
When you throw in gender, it gets even more colorful.
By 3 or 4, most kids identify with a gender.
I think 6 months into the womb, they're performed with a gender. Bill, you're a scientist.
And it doesn't always match the sex they were assigned at birth.
You are stupid. You are stupid. You are stupid. You are...
And a person's gender identity may change over their lifetime.
And culture is getting us new ways to express all of this. How you dress, how you act and talk, how you present yourself to the world. It should be up to you. Sure, this might make things confusing for those who insist everyone pick an M or an F. But people, we have to listen to the science.
What science? Bill, you didn't use one freaking sense of science in this entire presentation. This presentation's freaking stupid.
And the science says we're all on a spectrum. Our labels, our fashion, even our washrooms are still catching up to that truth. I think you'll find when we look at sexuality this way, it is more complicated, but it's also a lot more honest.
It's also a lot more mental if you think about it.
And it's more interesting. I learned a lot tonight. I mean, I'm this cis male guy who's been living in this world. But this stuff, to me, from a scientific standpoint, is just cool. Science is the process by which we understand nature, by which we understand our place in the world, how we all fit in. And so every one of these insights is just so exciting for me. We, working together, can, dare I say it, save the world.
Bill, you're a colossal disappointment. You use no science whatsoever, even though you are clearly a scientist. You wear the lab coat and everything. I mean, you are spiritually disabled. Spiritually stupid. Physically stupid. And those aren't even real things. But you are. Because it's science. Anyway, I hope you all like this. I wish Bill would return to him old self, but you know, when you ever get a spiritually stupid man and spiritually mental person in this face and place, well, there's just no getting him back. So, hope all of you enjoyed this video, and maybe we can knock some sense into those people that think there are more than two genders, and maybe we, you and me, can save the world. Well, I'm gonna go to bed, and I'll see y'all later. Woo!